Welcome back to Let's Play Daggerfall Unity. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. As I said off screen, I was gonna run back here off screen. Only took a second. Or a minute. But you guys, you know, you lucked out with it because it's raining outside, so you guys would have gotten all wet. So, I saved you from that. Let's take Thaumaturgy this time. Okay, good. I try to remember that. So we're... Thaumaturgy should go up to 5 whenever we rest next, or probably when we arrive at the whatever town or dungeon we're supposed to be going to. Yeah, it's pretty bad. Okay. So, this hopefully will be our final Mage's Guild quest. We have reputation 99. I just want to get to 100. And then I'll be satisfied. Villagers are running away. Oh, bad guys coming in. Actually, just in case I pick something that's not good. Because I did do a training, and I ran over here. Death's Embrace. I don't remember seeing that one. I think more of these appear as your reputation goes up, even though you've not risen in the ranks. So I'm kind of curious about the Death's Embrace. Persephone, I must speak in a low voice regarding this matter. Do not doubt you have seen and destroyed your share of liches in the Iliac Bay. No, I have not. They are usually not a foe to be deeply feared. Seriously? Well, this day we do have a foe to fear. We need someone to find a lich who has begun to make various undead appear across Alcair. What precisely the motivation for all this racket is, and see if any solution is forthcoming. We ask you specifically, Evoker, will you do this for us? I don't want to fight a lich right now. Then we are doomed. If you will not, who will? Let me just make sure my reputation didn't go down. I don't think it does for just turning down quests. No, I'm still reputation 99. I'm an Evoker, though. Yeah, I've been an Evoker, right? A month needs to pass, and then from whenever I risen in the ranks last, and then I'll go up again. Alright, so I don't want to do that. I mean, you figure it'd be a lich with a title like that. A lot of these I did. Research notes. Turning the research. A victim of shapeshifting? We have something of a rescue mission that needs an immediate counterpart. A good friend and member of the Mage's Guild, someone named Christina Wooding, has been cursed to take the form of an animal by shapeshifters, and no one has been able to cast off the spell. Long story short, the Fighters Guild is now on its way to slay our poor friend, believing her to be a legitimate animal in a house. Someone must go defend her. Is it you? Yeah, I'll try. I gotta take on the Fighters Guild. Well, not the entire Fighters Guild, you know. Well, I gave you the short version, and now the long one. The shape-shifting spell is advanced to the point that Christina Wooding actually thinks she is an animal. I feel certain she will attack you on sight. No matter what else happens in the Wixton residence, you must not slay her. That is an inviolable directive. Fight off the mercenaries who arrive and report to me when you are finished. I have here a book I think you will relish as a reward. Sweet, you got a book. And did I mention you must get there immediately? The Fighters Guild will already be on the move for now. Okay. Immediately. Oh, here in Alcair. Sleep spell, maybe? Thank you. mean immediately, because I'm gonna... Just in case... Have some kind of, like, paralyze or something. Yeah. Duration is how many rounds paralysis lasts. Chance of paralyzing target. What level am I? 5, right? Yeah. So that would make it 11. Casting cost 129. How much mana do I have? Where do I see that? Okay. 285 spell points. Of course, I don't want to make it all the spell points. But let's see... What would be a reasonable chance to paralyze somebody that I can cast? Plus, we want to increase the duration as well. That's the other thing. So if I get 5 per one level, that's 25, 26. That's too much. Although, that's... I might just have to be hit by it. Because I also want to have a duration. So this would be duration 16 rounds, which I think a round is 5 seconds? So that would be like a minute? Over a minute? Right? Let me just say, now we have to break out the calculator. 16. That would be 80 seconds. If I'm right about a round lasting 5 seconds. I think it's either 5 or 6 seconds. It's kind of silly to put rounds in a real-time game. And that decreases it drastically. That'll be 10, 11. This would last almost a minute, 55 seconds. If I do this, the chance is only 26%. That's horrible. I'll try sleep first. And it's a pretty hefty cost, too. Oh, see? That's my answer to my question from last episode. If I don't put a name in, because I put identify for identify. Hold person. Well, you know what? Actually, hold monster is a D&D name. But this is going to be hold monster or person, but it's not going to show up right in the grimoire. So if I go down, right, hold monster. I don't want to do it on you. Just wanted information. Well, oh. I never tried to look at a map inside here. That's pretty cool. Too bad I can't write notes. I'd put where all the trainers and stuff are. Of course, it would probably only apply to this mage's guild. By touch. Ah, here it says. You know, it'd be cool if it told you in this box, if it told you the outcome based on your level. If it changed, like at level 6, it would go up and say, you know, it would actually say how much chance. It's a computer. Computers can do that. And then sleep. Oh. This damage is fatigue, so I want paralyze. I'm thinking of sleep as actually putting someone to sleep. I mean, I guess eventually you could do that, maybe? Alright. Let me get out of my calculator here. I'll try to paralyze it, and if... It's really just one try, because then I gotta use, I gotta use the rest for restoration for these foes who arrive, and in case it doesn't work, because I have to just ignore the animal, I guess. Let it hit me as I fight the Fighters Guild. Okay, Wixton Resonance. Christina Wooding. You'd think she'd be in the Wooding Resonance. Don't look at me like that. I had to buy a spell. Wooding Resonance. Let's see, it's another one we... I gotta ask around. Or Wixton Resonance. You'll find it northwest with a bit of a walk. Thank you. On the map. Oh, it's not that much of a walk. Well now you guys are stuck out in the rain. I'm sorry about that. Can't be avoided sometimes, you know, weather. This one. This thing? It appears you have arrived in the nick of time. You can already hear multiple voices engaged in raucous discussion outside. Her name's Christina, though. It's not her. There's a monster. An animal. Oh, she's a spider? Crap. Well, they're gonna... I can't leave. They're gonna kill the monster. Where's my spell? Oh. Trying to stay between her and the monster. You hear no more shouting. Hopefully these are the last mercenaries sent to slay Christina Wooding. Is it? Okay. Dwarven mace. Steel mace. Steel warhammer. and all the steel stuff. I have to ignore the spider. Can't hurt it. Elven staff, couldn't even see it. That's interesting. Pretty hefty. Alright. I have to go back to get my reward and my reputation increase. Don't go in there, it's just a nasty spider. That's actually a human being. Hopefully at some point they manage to bring her back. Oh, I headed the wrong way. Bring her back to human form. I need to get my stamina and my mana back. Oh, what a hero! The spell will wear off by the latter part of the day, or perhaps even now it has. No. Not as soon as I walked out of there. But that will be too soon for more mercenaries to get word of it. Christina Wooding will know about your work and praise your name. You have truly saved a life this day. Take this magnificent book. Greywage? As my heartfelt thanks for protecting the innocent. Greywatch. We did it, guys. Reputation 100 with the Mage's Guild. Alright, so the game crashed. My old computer system crashed. I'm not sure what was going on. Loud out here. Getting from the rain here. So what I was gonna do, because the only thing I did was really, we only lost like 4 minutes. I looked at this note. Prince Lhotun and Castle Sentinel may be able to shed some light upon recent events involving Lysandus. So, we're going to go there next. It's not a quest that we can look up in our quest log. But what I was doing... Sentinel's somewhere... Yeah, Sentinel's over here. I could search for it, but there's only a few cities. It's right here. So the travel time is 51. So that's 51 days. Pretty long. We could go by ship. In which case... the travel time would be 12 days. But it would cost more. Not too much more. But I was thinking, what if I traveled to a port town and actually took a ship? You know, so I figured maybe that's, Wargate, where you just came from. The Laughing Cat Hostel. Oh, Cathborn was where I was going to go. So I was going to go to Cathborn and see if they have a harbor master, whatever they call it, there. So, I'm going to go do that. Traveling to Cathborn, that's when we crashed. So let me just restart the recording. So I don't lose that. I don't want to tell you this guy's this stuff over and over again. It's kind of annoying. Cathborn. Try it again here. Third time's a charm. There's a monument labeled in honor of the 162 soldiers who lost their lives in the Battle of Cathborn. Have your bag, assorted items. Thaumaturgy increased, improved. 5%, woohoo! Hello, High Elf. Wanna see my wares? You might find something you like. My name is Morgona Yomwing, by the way. No. She really wanted us to get that bracer. So maybe it's only in big towns we see the guy standing outside? In big cities? More cities? I saw a Spriggan over there for a second. Oh. I wonder if that was a mage's guild. These guys are right on the water, I thought. I'm gonna have to go through the menu. Butterflies. Yeah, there's the water. Two soldiers approach you. Hey, got a map? Can you please point us to Yomsley Banner? These Yomsley people. We're supposed to be there in 15 days, yes. Show them your map. Thank you, one of them says before tossing a couple coins your way. Literally, it's just a couple coins. You're the one looking for the map? I guess so. They don't like to stand close to each other. They both have a rank odor about them. So they keep their distance. Yeah, I mean, there's water. We're literally going this way. Across, I guess, around the mountain. Isle of Balfiera. Singbury. Blackhead and Upvale, that's all that's on here, and then this is part of it. Singbrug. Gallow Market. Warwick. That's it. Interesting. But anyway, we need to get to Sentinel. Let me save. Just restarting the recording again, just in case. Actually gonna do this. My normal thing. And let's go to Sentinel by boat. Where's the boat? I don't know. Restoration skill improved. We did not crash. Yay. There's a monument labeled to the memory of the 110 soldiers who lost their lives in the Battle of Sentinel. Yep. Now you're here. Cool, though. So we're in Hammerfell now, aren't we? This side is Hammerfell. Is there also a region called Hammerfell? I mean, I know it's a province. Alakir Desert, yeah. For some reason I thought there was a capital of Hammerfell called Hammerfell. No? Okay. Mornoth. And then you got this other... You got a few of these islands. Just a few locations on them. That's all that's here is the Cybeads. And then Bethany has White Fort. The Howling Griffin Hostel. And the Green Woodchuck Lodge. And Kirkbeth Hamlet. Kirkhead Rock. And the Crimson Scorpion Lodge. Oh, you know, I don't have everything. I didn't have everything up. So there are more things. The Inner Omen of Mara. The Wixley Graveyard. Hawk House Hall. The Green Woodchuck Lodge. The Moorfield Farmstead. White Goat Inn. Shining Light of Mara. Altar of Eric. Eric? Gentle Martyr of Mara. So Mara is well represented. Well represented on this island. And this still just has Cybeads. And this has a bunch more. The Crypts of Kingham with a capital TH. Upvale. Shrine of Vigril. Jode Shrine. Coppering Orchard. Kingston Farmstead. Singbury. Wait. The Buckingwing Farmstead. The Hearthsmith Farmstead. And now we have two things on this island. As well, the Gearsmith Orchard. There's a few things here. It's interesting. The Morehouse Farmstead. The Ash Stun Crypts. Gallow Market, we saw. Kingsley Orchard. Two on here, the Ash Smith's Farmstead. That's the same thing. Where do we see the other one? Ashes and Crypts and the Farmstead's here. Warwick, we saw. And then there's two things here. The Gearhouse Plantation and Old Lizasa's Farm. Interesting. But we're at Sentinel. Restoration increased. It's a minor 35%. I guess I get where I put these. Interesting. So I'm betting that's the palace where we need to find Lhotun? Is that his name? Lhotun? Prince Lhotun. Alright, so let's head... Yeah, this way. It's our first time in Hammerfell. Haven't been since the Elder Scrolls Arena. Cool, look at that. Oh, it's got one of those crystals. Nice. Is that what it is? Oh, shard. It's a shard. Oh, we gotta go in the water to get it. That's a mod that's been added. Luck increased by one. There are four left to find in the Sentinel region. Sweet. So it'll randomly increase your stat just by one. And they're kind of hard to find. It's only the second one I think I found. Or maybe the third. I think I did find another one. One of them is right by... when you come out of the dungeon. I don't know what... I forget what it's called. Gothway Gardens? At Gothway Gardens. What did it say it was? Over here? Wait. Is it just called Gothway? It says over here. Yeah. There's one right by it. Well, it's actually not by the town. It's actually when you come out of the dungeon. When you come out of, what's the name of that dungeon? Hold on. I could find it in short order. So I could just remember names better. Hold on a second. It's called Where is it? Privateer's Hold. Oh. It's over here, right? Gothway Garden. I wish I could zoom in. Now, where did it say it was? I thought you traveled just north to get there. Hold on. Probably because I have dungeons off. Yeah. Privateer's Hold, Gothway Garden, and it takes you like a few minutes to walk, and these are like basically right on top of each other. But right when you come out of Privateer's Hold is one of those shards. Shards of Daggerfall, I think the mod's called. Something like that. Okay. So we're heading for the castle. I got distracted. Oh, I'm gonna see my luck too. Luck is 47. Still not considered especially lucky. I'm average, yeah. Oh, imagine climbing that. I'd want to wait till my skill. Oh, you only have one name. Roldka. Shushta. These people only have one name. Look at that. Furtsy? Shig. As opposed to, you know, obviously. In the Daggerfall region, everyone has different names. Vibictus Yomsley and stuff like that. That's interesting, though. Okay, there's gotta be a way in here. I don't want to climb. Ah! Cool. He is pretty cool looking. He looks like a Mayan temple or something. Wow. And you can walk around all the perimeter here as well. Don't mind me, I'm just exploring. Hello down there! They don't exactly look like ants, not yet. What's that? Oops. I went off of... yeah. I was trying to zoom in. Wrong game. Hail. The guard by the door intones in a bored voice. All those having business with King Akarithi pass through the door at the back of the hall. I don't have business with Prince Lhotun? Is he a prince? Yeah, he's a Prince Lhotun. Cridgen. Mesta. Where does this go? I don't know if I'm supposed to be going through those doors. Kevja? Pretty. Lady Northbridge? Shaking her head. No. Lord Vossick? Prince Lhotun! Welcome to Sentinel, Persephone. I guess you must have received my letter. I know some things about Lysandus and why he might be haunting Daggerfall, but before I tell you, you have to promise to do something for me first. Is that alright? Sure. You will? Think, RK. You see, I used to have an older brother, 10 or 11 years older than me, named Lugar. You're not sure whether he's 10 or 11 years older than you? Whenever I ask what happened to him, I'm told a different story. Some say he got sick and died. Some say he was kidnapped by the Underking. Not the Underking. I want to know the truth. If you can find some proof of what really happened to him, I'll tell you all I know about King Lysandus. Whenever I click him, I hear that sound. Hey, click. He's a wild boy, I guess. NR, I don't know what that means. Missing Prince. Prince Lhotun of Sentinel has asked me to investigate the death of his brother Lugar, supposedly kidnapped by the Underking years ago. I guess I need to start asking people. Lord Vossick? Oh, he doesn't speak. Tell me about Lugar. Do you really think I'd tell a high elf even if I did know? What the hell makes you think I know or would tell you anything about Lugar? Yeah, that's why she's shaking her head now. This conversation has grown tiresome. Leave me now, Persephone. Well, that was quick. How droll. I only help to people of importance, those who have titles and lands. Now go away. Oh, nice. These questions are taxing my time, even if I knew about Lugar. Avail yourself of the nearest exit. Salt of the earth, these people. Maybe this little kid? Flirt-E? I despise your kind, just go away. The arm? The arm? I had one once, but the wheel fell off. Would you hold my foot while I get a drink of air? Okay, you're insane. Well, I guess we need to go outside and start asking the people of Sentinel who might know about Lugar. Yeah, I have a few things I wanna... Well, just that. We gotta start asking around about Lugar. I mean, who knows if anyone here really knows? I might be supposed to go somewhere else? I don't know. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.